This video is thanks to Women in Trading and Technology, a 3-day online program run by Jane Street in September 2020. If you're a woman at university considering a career in trading or technology, or you know someone that description matches, there is a link in the video description below and more details at the end of the video. Today I'm going to try a calculator challenge sent in by a maths teacher friend of mine, Sheena. I'm going to give it a go on the old Casio. I've got the FX83 GT Plus out for today. Big fan. I mean, big fan of just Casio calculators in general, as I've made very clear previously. So the way this works is you take your calculator, you type in 11, and then apparently you go to the power of 6, and then you divide that whole thing by 13, pretty straightforward, and then you hit equals, and as you can see, the answer is a rational multiple of pi. But pi, but it's Casio. I don't under. But pi is irrational. It can't be equal to a fraction. A transcendental number is not the root of any integer polynomial.
Wait a minute.
Okay, so what I think has happened here is the calculator just got a little bit overexcited trying to find pi, and frankly, I know how it feels. I also do that often in places where I probably shouldn't, and I can't stay mad at you. I mean, we've got so much in common, that's why we get on so well. You shouldn't have been looking for pi there. And when Sheena tweeted this, a lot of people did reply with variations on, yes, you did ask it what this is, and it said it equals that, but it doesn't mean equals, it means approximately, because obviously there's going to be some rounding and stuff going on in there. It's only got a finite amount of memory. It's just roughly. And as a way of demonstrating how close it is, some people rearrange this to see what the approximation of pi would be. And if you take the value that comes out of this and you compare it to the actual value of pi, it's pretty close. That matches for the first 12 decimal places. That is not bad. And so that's kind of case close, I guess. It's just, it was trying to find pi and it was so close, it got overexcited. Or is that the whole story? Just to be sure, let's go through the calculator's logic one step at a time, because I don't think the people online are correct. So when you type in 11 to the power of 6 divided by 13, first of all, the calculator does just work out what that is numerically. But before it shows that to you, it has a think. It's like, I wonder if there's a more insightful way to represent that. What if the person's doing a calculation that's like, you know, trigonometry or something involving angles? Maybe that would be nicer and more insightful if it was a multiple of pi. So very quickly, it divides it by pi just to see what it would be as a multiple of pi. And to be fair, every number can be written as a multiple of pi. It's whether or not that's useful. So it looks at the number out the front and goes, I wonder if that's meant to be like a rational number. Is that a neat fraction? Now to check that, well, okay, to start with, there is a whole number on the front. And so we can get rid of that and we can ignore pi for a second. This is the section we're worried about. Is that meant to be a rational number? How could we approximate that as a ratio of two integers? There's the lazy way where you just put it over some power of 10 and you hope for the best. Maybe we can simplify that, maybe we can't. We can do so much better. Now, because we've discarded the whole bit, what we're left with will be some value between 0 and 1. So let's say it's roughly here. What we do now is we start with 0/1 at one end, and we start with 1/1 at the other end, and then we gradually work our way in, squeezing towards an exact value. And I'm gonna use a technique called the Farey approach or algorithm, named after Farey addition, or I call it naive fraction addition. That's where you just add the two numerators, the top bits, and then add the denominators. And if you do it in this case, you'll end up, oh, it's on my face, there you go. You end up with a half, because 0 plus 1 is 1, and 1 plus 1 is 2. A quick aside with some fun facts about the naive fraction sum, in case you're not familiar with them. This process of adding the top and bottom is often called the mediant, and that's because even though it doesn't give you the actual sum of the fractions, it's always guaranteed to give you a new fraction which falls between the original two fractions. Not only that, but if you do start at 0 and 1 and you continually do this, you will get every rational number in that range expressed as its most simplified fraction. But of course, for our purposes, we don't want all the rational numbers. We want to get one very close to a very specific point. The way the algorithm works is you then look to see which of the two sections the number is in, and because it's in the one over there, we can discount this limit. We've now got a smaller range we're looking at, and we repeat. We take the next naive sum of the fractions, add the tops, add the bottoms, and we have a look at it, and we go, okay, it's between a third and a half, so we can get rid of zero now, and then repeat. Oh, it's in there, we can get rid of a half. And if you keep going over and over again, you keep adding, seeing which section it's in, discarding the one that's outside, eventually you will hone in on it. And you could carry on for as long as you want. I ran this algorithm, I coded it up in Python, I put in this number, and I set a limit of 10,000. So I didn't want any numbers bigger than that, and eventually it came back with not a bad approximation, 1,213 over 3,600. And I assume this is what the Casio did. It got that approximation and went, okay, I'll put that back in instead of having all those decimal places, and now I'll tidy it up. So I've got the original whole bit plus the fraction. I can put that together into an improper fraction multiplied by pi. That's pretty good. And because that is such a good rational approximation of the answer, for some reason the calculator just goes, that must be it. And so that is what it puts on the screen. And as we saw before, it matches the first 12 decimal places of pi, which is not a bad way to measure the success. And that's what everyone was saying online, that the Casio had just found such a close match to a multiple of pi that it couldn't tell the difference, and so it served it up as the exact answer. But because I had now coded the Farey algorithm to find rational approximations, I thought, well, okay, if that's what the calculator is doing, this shouldn't be the only time it gets it wrong. Surely I can find another case. And so I had a quick dig around and I came up with this one here. 17 to the power of 5 is incredibly close. In fact, it's even better. If you reverse pi out of this, you get a 13 decimal place match. So surely the same thing's gonna happen. So 17 to the power of 5, I'm gonna divide that whole thing by 11. And no, it didn't do it. But Casio, why? If this one trips the pi detect, doesn't this one? People might say, oh, okay, hang on, it's a bit different. Like, the numerator is a lot bigger. Okay, I found one that's incredibly similar. What if we do 13 to the 6 divided, this time, by 17? And that also matches for 12 digits. That should be the same. Okay, let me just pop that one in now. So this time, we've got 11 instead to the power of 6, and the whole thing is divided by 17. No! It's even got the same multiple of 360 underneath in case that's what the Casio was looking at, but it didn't work. And because I had Python code to find these, I just kept generating them. This one here, that will give you 15 digits match when you use it to approximate pi. All of these, they're all incredibly close. They're all the same idea, but none of them work. None of these trip the detector on the Casio. It doesn't represent anything else as a multiple of pi. It's only 11 to the power of 6 divided by 13. In just quickly, for the record, in case it offered any insight, I did track Sheena's tweet back to its origin, which was a Reddit post. But when I spoke to the user who made that post, they said they just happened to compute 11 to the 6 divided by 13 while doing calculations for a number theory class. It wasn't on purpose. So we found it by accident. It's the only one that does this, and I have no idea why it works. So what's going on in there? Are you using a different way to approximate a number as a rational? Is there something strange happening in the binary? I don't know. Why can I not find any other example that works? Why just that one? Why only 11 to the 6 divided by 13? I thought I knew you. I thought I knew my Casio, but I don't. Why? Only 11 to the 6 divided by 13. Don't worry about them, I'm sure they will be fine, but if you can try 11 to the power of 6 divided by 13 on any calculator, can you tell us below what calculator you were using and if you got a multiple of pi as the answer? And if you can find any calculation which gives a multiple of pi when it shouldn't on any device, please do send in the details. On behalf of both of us, we would really love to hear about that. And I should thank the supporter of today's video. It's the Women in Trading and Technology event hosted by Jane Street, who very kindly support the Stand Up Maths channel. This is for women who are currently in their penultimate year of university and are considering a career in either quantitative trading or software engineering. So if you are such a person or you know someone like that, the 3-day Jane Street event is a fantastic thing to attend to find out more about those sorts of careers. It's been running for 6 years, and this is the first year it won't be a physical event at the London office of Jane Street, but rather it will be online, which is a bit of a shame, but makes it easier than ever to attend. So if you're considering using mathematics in either quantitative trading or software engineering, because they've got a strand for each of those, check out the link which is on screen right now, or it's in the top line of the description. Check it out. It's a great opportunity to find out more about these fantastically mathematical career options. Okay, I better go check on other Matt to make sure they're okay. But I mean, from both of us, thanks for watching.